Have a look at these vibrations. My car's shaken better than Steven's. And it's all coming from the tyres, so I need a tyre balance.
So the question is, can you really balance your tyres by putting some ceramic beads into them? Well, I hope it's true, because it's almost impossible to find a tyre service that can balance wheels like this, because these rims don't fit on a standard spin balancer. Well, let's put some beads in here and do some measurements and we'll find out. Here is my test setup. I fixed a phone to the front axle and I'm running a vibration meter app on it. The front left wheel is in the air and the right one stays on the ground. I can start and stop the measurements remotely from my laptop in the car. My first measurement is without any wheel on, just the naked hub. I speed up the engine until the speedometer shows about 60 km per hour, and the differential will double the speed on the left wheel. So it will spin as fast as if I were driving about 120 km per hour. Then I start the measurement for about 5 seconds. And here we have a maximum of 5.8 modified Mercalli intensity, that's a unit MMI, and an average of 4.8 MMI. So these are the vibrations from the engine and the drivetrain only. Next, I put a wheel on that has been balanced by a tire shop. It shows a max of 7.1 and a mean of 6.6 MMI. Then I tested an unbalanced wheel, and as we can see, it produced even more vibration. The results of my measurements are as to be expected, so I believe my test setup works. Okay, now I want to put those beads into my tires, and I found a few small problems here that need to be fixed. Number one is the beads come with a table that tells you the weight of the beads that have to go into the tire. First problem is that the weight is in rosettes. I have no idea what rosettes are. Second problem is the table doesn't contain the tire size for a Citroën 2CV. So I made some inquiries and 60 grams should be definitely enough for a 5 kg tire, like the ones we have on our 2CVs. Now comes the problem how to put the beads into the tire. And I found on the internet an easy way to do it, and that is through the valve stem. Problem here is that that doesn't work, because at least the beads I got are a bit too thick for fitting into a valve stem. So now I'll have to break the tire, seal the tire bead to put those little bolts in. That's also what the instructions say. The problem here is I have never done this before. This method here doesn't work.
Okay, method number two, high lift jack and Land Rover.
And now put these tire beads in, and you have to be careful that not one or two of these beads gets stuck between the rim and the rubber, because then the tire seal won't seal anymore. And then you pump up the tire and it will pop back onto the rim. Now make sure that the rubber and the metal are clean first, and you can use a little bit of grease, but make sure not to use too much grease, because if grease goes into the tire, then the beads may not move freely anymore, and they have to move freely to work properly.
So here we go again, this time with beads in the tire, accelerating to 60, and the average over 5 seconds is 8.4. Now that is the worst result ever, so the beads have increased the vibrations here. But fortunately, after a few seconds, things calm down and the vibrations disappear. So I did another measurement, and this time it came to 6.4.
I've tried a few more times, and sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. It seems that the beads sometimes get stuck. Well, let's try this small scale experiment here first. This is a remote control car, and I've replaced one of its wheels with a biscuit tin. And now I create an imbalance. 15 grams will do. And here you can see that my wheel wobbles because of the imbalance. Now add 3 metal balls to the tin and start up again. And the metal balls have made the vibrations worse first. And then, after a while, suddenly
the whole system becomes balanced. And you can see here in slow motion that the three balls have arranged themselves opposite my imbalance, my heavy spot, which is marked by the arrow here on the tin. So this means, in principle, balancing a wheel using beads or balls works. You may ask yourself, why didn't I use balancing beads to demonstrate this? Well, I tried, but it never worked. The beads always got stuck somewhere, it seems. So how does this bead balancing really work? Now here's a common explanation. You have a heavy spot creating the imbalance, and this heavy spot, through its centrifugal forces, drags the wheel around. It pulls up the suspension when it goes up, and it pulls it down when it goes down. The problem with that is that it's not correct, at least not at higher speeds at which the vibrations in a car typically occur. In reality, a car wheel that causes a high-speed vibration wobbles in exactly the opposite way. Now that's completely counterintuitive, but you can prove in your bathtub that that in fact is true. The only thing you need is a bathtub and a frisbee or a tin of biscuits. Now you put some weights on one side and spin it and see what happens. If you look carefully, you will see that it wobbles and that the heavy spot is actually closer to the center of the rotation. This means it's not the heavy spot that is wobbling and flailing around. It is the other side. And this is because a freely rotating body will always spin around its center of gravity. And a rotating body that is tied to an axle like a wheel will equally push and pull onto that axle to try to rotate around its center of gravity. And the center of gravity of an unbalanced wheel with a heavy spot is closer to the heavy spot. Let's have a look at one bead only here, the one in blue. It is where the heavy spot is. It describes a slightly elliptical path. It doesn't matter, it's almost like a circle. And now have a look at this red bead here, which is on the opposite side. It also describes a slightly elliptical path. Now the important thing is that the red bead describes a larger path, a larger circle, than the blue bead. And if you do the mathematics, you will find that the centrifugal forces are stronger when the radius is larger. Now this means there are more centrifugal forces where the red bead is than where the blue bead is. And the beads will always roll towards the spot with the highest centrifugal forces. This explains the static imbalance, but how about dynamic imbalance? That's when the heavy spot is off the tire's center line. That's the type of imbalance that shakes your steering left and right. Have a look at this top view here, looking from the top onto a tire at the moment when the heavy spot is pointing forwards, and you see it here on the left of the center line. The heavy spot will have the tendency to move towards the center of rotation. Again, it's a bit counterintuitive, but the bathtub doesn't lie. This will cause the wheel to steer slightly to the left, and because of the inertia, the beads, which will be on the other side, will move also to the left, balancing the tire again, this time dynamically. So now it's time for a test drive to see if the balancing beads work in real life. There's only one last question here. Why do the beads work well on the road, but only sometimes when the wheel is spinning off the ground? Mathematics gives us the answer here too. If you do the calculation, you will find that the centrifugal force that pushes the bead into the inside of the tire is much higher than the force that pulls the bead towards its balancing location. This is the equivalent of a very heavy car trying to roll down a very slight incline. It won't start moving without a push.
And the beads also need a push, and it comes through this, the flat spot. That's where the rubber meets the road. And it is this interaction with the road that pushes the beads out of their stuck position so they can start moving towards the position where they need to be. That's all for me now. Goodbye.